TV WQMY, your regional sports leader.
I'm Erin Dugan from Fox 56 Sports, and welcome to week two of high school football on my TV WQMY. Tonight, we're in the Wyoming Valley Conference for a quad A battle between Berwick and Dallas. The talk of the game will be about the matchup of former King's College coach Rich Minnello, now at Dallas, against his friend and former Wilkes University coach Frank Sheptock. Berwick has appeared in the last four District 2 AAA finals, while Dallas is searching to reach the district playoff for the second year in a row. Let's get you out to this week's Rivalry of the Week.
The Berwick Bulldogs showed why they are the team to beat in District 2 4A with a huge win over Hazleton last week.
You know, last year Berwick struggled a little bit from an offensive standpoint, and hopefully we can, you know, produce some more yards, productivity, time of possession, those types of things that will give us an advantage to win.
Dallas lost to Coughlin last week. The Mountaineers know good things are on the horizon, though, for this young team.
Each team has its own personality, so it's kind of neat that it's starting to develop with this group. You know, really in the last month or so, you could see it taking on its own personality, so it's exciting.
It's a Wyoming Valley Conference showdown between two old friends. Next.
Ladder, good.
Let's go. He's Cassini, shifty. Gonna go in for a Berwick touchdown. No flags on the play, 45 yards.
And he explodes for a long touchdown run to the Bulldogs.
You're watching the Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY.
It's a beautiful, easy drive up Route 309 through the back mountain. Whether you're headed to Harvey's Lake, Januzzi's Pizza, Misericordia University, or our stop tonight, Dallas High School. Welcome everyone to Mountaineer Stadium, where a big crowd is expected for the Battle of the Blues. Good evening, everyone. I'm Bob Eide. Erin Dugan will join us shortly on the sideline. My partner in the booth tonight, former radio sportscaster Joe Thomas. And Joe and Frank Sheptock took the job at Berwick. This was an easy one to mark on the calendar. It's an old reunion between two old rivals.
Yeah, Frank Sheptock and Rich Minnello of Dallas, they coached against each other 14 times on the college ranks. This is the first time in high school. These guys are friends. They talk to each other during the week. This is one they're looking forward to.
Let's talk about Berwick first. An easy win over Hazleton and a big game from their running back, Lenny Wyda.
Yeah, Lenny Wyda, 20 carries, 182 yards, three touchdowns in the first half. They put Berwick out in front early. If that happens tonight, Dallas has got to watch it because it could get out of hand.
Let's talk of the Mountaineers. They lost to Coughlin, but the positive side, they got a huge game from their running back, Justin Hutchins.
Yeah, they have a lot of players in the skill positions without much experience. Hutchins is one that has it. 173 yards, scored their only touchdown last week. He's going to have to do the same thing tonight.
Well, the reunion is all set. The friendship, well, it's going to be on hold for just a little while. It's Berwick and Dallas. The opening kickoff and the starting lineups are on the way.
You're watching the Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY. The Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY is brought to you in part by Wendy's. Quality is our recipe. Luzerne County Community College. Einan Buick GMC. Sylvester Chevrolet. And your local Ford store. Check out every new Ford car, truck, SUV, and crossover at buyfordnow.com today.
Only Wendy's can make the Baconator, because while some other guys use frozen beef from far away,
that's 9,429 miles away.
Wendy's only uses fresh beef from ranches close by,
so we don't have to freeze it.
Then add six strips of bacon, cooked fresh in an oven, never a microwave. Tossed with plenty of
cheese,
without a single veggie to get in the way.
Aww. Proving once and for all
that only Wendy's has the bacon and the ater to make the Baconator.
Are you ready? I'm ready to learn the skills that lead to a career, not just a job. I'm ready to earn a degree, not a lot of debt. I'm ready for a powerful degree that will transfer to other colleges and universities. My mind is ready. I'm ready for Luzerne County Community College.
We are back at Mountaineer Stadium in Dallas, getting set for this big Wyoming Valley Conference matchup between Berwick and Dallas. The third member of our crew tonight, as always, Aaron Dugan, down on the field.
Well, Bob, it's been quite a while since Dallas beat Berwick. It's been 5 years, actually, all the way back in 2011. And that was the year Dallas went 10-2 and made it to the district final. Now, a lot's changed here at Mountaineer Stadium since that game 5 years ago. They now have turf. They now have lights. But one thing has stayed the same. They still want to beat Berwick bad. Bob, back to you.
That they do, Aaron. And it is a beautiful night of week two of high school football. You couldn't ask for much better. It's about 71 degrees outside. It will go down to the 60-degree mark. The wind's very light and very low humidity, Joe Thomas. And that will play advantage, you think, maybe for Dallas?
I think maybe for Dallas because they've got a lot more players that play both ways. And to get rid of some of this heat and humidity might give these guys' legs a little extra power near the end of the game.
Dallas won the toss. They elected to receive. So that means Ken Marshman, the junior, will tee it up for Berwick. And there you see back to receive Christian Motley, number 24, and number 13, David Schuster, for the Mountaineers. The bands are ready, the fans are in their seats, and we are ready for week two of high school football on MyTV. This will be Schuster from his four. Brings it up nicely, up past the 20-yard line, and that's where the Mountaineers will start their first possession.
Schuster, with a little slip at the beginning, might have been able to gather a few more yards.
So here are your starters for the offense for the Mountaineers. 217 yards last week, and Stone Minello gets the start at quarterback. He was the wide receiver last year, and yes, he is the son of the head coach. Chris Murray is at the tight end. Two catches last week for 16 yards, and that left side of the line, which we'll take a look at in a second, will have to play dominant tonight. Manello with the keeper. Gets a nice block. Couple of yards up past the 22.
Brought down by number six, Mike Ford.
Okay. So Jason Anderson and Michael Farah on the left side. Getting tested early on, Joe.
And Manello rolls out to his left, and I think maybe fooled the Berwick defense a little bit, although I think his dad might have liked him to stay in bounds and keep that clock running. The more time Dallas can take off the clock is the less time that Berwick's spread offense is going to have.
Up quickly, they hand it off, and a big stop for Berwick on the other side by Kyle Roberts, a defensive end. So a third down on the way for the Mountaineers.
That was Hutchins, the big star from last week, and I don't think he gained much on that one. But you will see Dallas keep testing that left side because of their offensive line, and that is something that we'll talk about a little bit throughout the night. Mike Farrell, 6'1", 263-pound senior, number 73, and Jason Anderson, a couple big guys out there.
Manello looking to pass. Puts a shoulder down up to the 30. It'll be a little bit short of a first down. Looks like Dallas will have to punt.
Well, they're going to be about 2 yards short, and this is going to bring out Dallas's special teams. This is something that Coach Rich Manello has been working on. You see Manello, the quarterback, roll out, and he does a pretty good job trying to get the yardage, but just comes up short. Charles Giacometti of Kevin Klinger.
Jason Anderson will do the kicking. The big lineman, he hangs a high one.
And that's Klinger who made the tackle. Yeah.
Klinger is back and he's hit quickly. Berwick's first possession will be at the 36-yard line. So now here are the starters for the Berwick Bulldogs. 44 points last week against Hazleton. Jared Marshman gets the start at quarterback. He's a junior, 111 yards last week, two touchdowns. He was the backup a year ago. Wide receivers, Harrison Kuchka returns. He had a nice year last year, 6 catches, 136 yards. Big, experienced offensive lineup from Kyle Pierce, getting looks at Ivy League schools, Patriot League schools. He's a 4-year starter at right guard. Big catch. Matt Champ, and Berwick scores on their first play of the game.
Matt Champ, who just broke out on the left-hand side, got past his man, and the ball was right there at his hands. It was just a foot race, and no one was going to catch him going down.
62 yards. Marshman hung it up there, Joe.
Yeah, watch. Perfect pass right on the hands, and from then on, it's just...
Well, they went after the freshman quarterback who got the start, Leonard Kelly. So Frank Sheptock doing his homework early on. Marshman in for the extra point. It is up and it is good. So the Bulldogs are here to play. They lead 7-0 with 9:47 remaining in the first.
Shift into savings now at your local Kubota dealer. Take command of your lawn care needs with a new Kubota Commander zero-turn mower. Get commercial-grade performance and a full 4-year factory warranty at a price you can afford. Now get special promotional pricing of $38.99 and zero down and 0% financing for 4 years. See your local Kubota dealer today.
Visit your local Kubota dealer, pakubotadealers.com.
Learn to see.
Learn to speak.
B-b-bail.
Awesome.
Learn to solve. Ready to inject the sample?
Learn the balance. Nice.
Learn to fly.
So after the kickoff, Dallas will start their second possession at the 25-yard line. Joe, 51 points in 2 weeks for Berwick. This offense looked really unstoppable.
Yeah, and that's what we've been talking about. It's a spread offense. They keep things going. First play through the air, and Dallas is going to have to keep the ball on the ground, keep the clock moving to keep the Berwick offense off the field.
Hutchins, the second man through, not much running room up the middle, and talk about a dominant offensive line against a bigger defensive line, Joe, and really they outweigh each other maybe by 30 pounds.
It's really amazing, some of the size of the kids on both of these teams. A lot of guys in the 260s, few in the 270s, so they've got some big boys up front on both sides.
Chase Struthers, 6'4", 303-pounder, number 70 for Berwick, made the stop. Big rush. Manello on the run. Can't find anybody. Wisely throws it out of bounds. And now here's the defense for Berwick, pitching a shutout last week against Hazleton, and they look unstoppable already.
Kyle Roberts, the player there who was chasing Manello all throughout the backfield, step for step, forcing the Dallas quarterback to toss it out of bounds.
Another guy looking at Division I schools, Kyle Roberts, number 56, the defensive end. Anthony Cicini moves over from a quarterback position. He'll play linebacker. He's gained a little weight, 190 pounds right now. He's a senior. Mike Force, the backup quarterback, the starting quarterback last year. He's now a wide receiver and a free safety. So watch out, a lot of athleticism out of him. So Manello on third and long again. He's going to send it back the other way. And Joe, early on at least, it's been a dominant defense for Berwick.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And I think Dallas is a little jittery, too, in this game this evening. They're forcing things, and they just don't look comfortable out on the field at this point.
seating.
So there you see the Dallas coaching staff and 20 underclassmen on the roster for the Mountaineers. Rich Manello will tell you this is a young rookie team. He calls them his puppies at this point. Another high kick from Anderson. I think it hit a Dallas player in the back, so the ball will be at the 42-yard line.
And once again, Berwick with some really good field position at their own 48. So Dallas is not helping themselves out here early in this game. Two threes and outs and two punts. One offensive play for Berwick, and they are up 7-0.
So Jared Marshman's the backup quarterback to Mike Force last year. 22 of 55, 438 yards, three touchdowns. Frank Sheptock early on makes the call to go with him as quarterback. A lot of confidence, I would think, for the junior going into the year.
I would think so when you've got a coach like that that wants to have you play. There's Wida getting his first carry of the night. Well, it's only the second really play from scrimmage for Berwick, so he's already in one half of their plays. But
no huddle, quick offense. Quarterback keep, nice stop. Farrell out there, number looks like 73.
And Michael Farrell is the kid that they're talking about up here in Dallas. You'll watch this. And he's right there. A lot of Division I schools are looking at him. Runs a 4.85 40. And he's just getting stronger as the year progresses.
Opportunity for Dallas to get off the field. Good catch by Force on the outside as Schuster went for the tip. Missed it. Berwick inside Dallas territory at the 42.
Yeah, when you're in Dallas's position and you have a team that's as young as them, sometimes you have to gamble. And Schuster gambled there a little bit. Didn't work out, but good effort on his part. Good play by Berwick.
Make that the 45-yard line, but the chains are moved. Force jet sweep, running room. Give him nine.
And Mike Force, he was the quarterback last year on the Berwick Bulldogs, a team that did so well in head coach George Curry's final year. And now he's at wide receiver in a deal where Frank Sheptock, a lot like Rich Manello, using guys at their best position instead of where they've been.
Second and short on the way. Like
that was wide
through again, and here is the defense quickly for Dallas. We talked about Farrell up front last year, 63 tackles for him, 4 sacks, 9 for a loss. Linebackers will be tested. Ronald Ostrowski, the only man with some experience back there, 17 tackles a year ago. And Stone Manello, he'll be tested at that free safety position. He'll either have to come up and stop the run or help out the corners on the pass.
Officials talking to both.
Oh, we have our first flag of the game, looks like.
Teams out there, here we go.
Face mask, on a defense, 15 yards, first down.
There's our referee, Patrick Will, tonight. So you heard the call, something Dallas does not want to do.
They don't need to do that. They don't need to do that is help Berwick out on offense. And they just gave them 15 extra yards and bring the ball up to the 16-yard line.
That was one positive Dallas could take away from last week, Joe. Just 3 penalties for 10 yards in total last week, but a big one right there.
And that's impressive on the first week of the season, too.
Wide a shifty going through. Inside the 5, first and goal, Bulldogs.
Wow, that was a nice run by Len Wida as he jukes left and then goes right and then comes back behind those big Berwick offensive linemen.
Wida again. Touchdown, Berwick.
And Wida on the kick. And the play is good for Berwick. Touchdown.
So an impressive drive from the Bulldogs.
Well, Berwick picking up where they left off last week. They got off to a quick early start against Hazleton, and now they're doing the same here against the Mountaineers, 13-0, and barely 5 minutes taken off the clock.
Number eight, Evan
seven plays, 57 yards, and this is what Rich Minnell had feared. Ken Marshman, the kick is good, and the Bulldogs now lead 14-0, 6:53 remaining in the first.
Take a look at this, and Wider just powers through 2 yards, just follows his blocks, and stays low to the ground.
Well, we haven't seen him yet, but we expect wide receiver Anthony Cicini, number 26, to have a big game out there. He hasn't caught anything. And Sikowski and Motley, the two cornerbacks who were supposed to start, Joe, they're going to be tested, and the cornerbacks were tested already.
Yeah, no doubt about that. And we saw in warm-ups four different quarterbacks taking snaps as far as a practice. And you wonder if Coach Minnello, with his back up against the wall, might change things up a bit.
So Marshman will tee it up now for the third time already in the first quarter.
This is where the Mountaineers need a big play to be made on special teams to loosen them up a little bit, give them some field position.
Looks like Schuster again from the 10. Schuster breaks a couple tackles, but the Berwick special teams playing well up to the 30. You need a first down if you're Dallas. You need to control something positive, Joe, I think, at this point.
And you need to stay in bounds. You need to eat some of that clock away so Berwick doesn't have that much offense.
One of the Wendy's keys to the game, sustain and finish drives. We need a drive if you're Dallas.
I think they've got to keep the ball on the ground. I'm not confident in their passing performances here.
They do, but big Chase Struthers is right there for the stop, along with Tom Monaco at 290.
Yeah, just running up the middle and running into a brick wall, so to speak. Look at that, number 70.
Second and 10.
Chase Struthers. 6'4", 303. He's just a junior. He'll be back again next year, folks.
Ball is bobbled a bit, but picked back up on this turf. So third and long on the way for the third straight time. And this is not in the playbook if you're Dallas.
No, not many plays right here, third and 11 for Dallas.
That was Schuster who bobbled the ball. So I don't know how many third and 11 calls Rich Minnello has with this offense. This is a key 4A game, both teams in that division. Pass across the middle, taken by Christian Motley, but he was quickly taken down by Anthony Cicini.
Man, Cicini leveled him. They got 3 yards on the play, but watch this. Boom.
66, Michael Anderson in punt formation for the Mountaineers.
We mentioned him, Joe, early on, and how he looks a lot bigger than he did a year ago, Cicini, and you saw it right there on the tackle.
Bulldogs.
Low snap. Oh!
It's blocked. Recovered by Dallas, but Berwick will have the ball in Mountaineer territory. They're going to call it the 20-yard line.
And this first quarter has could not have gone worse for the Dallas Mountaineers.
Joseph Miller.
Low snap.
Bulldogs will take over first and 10.
Tough to handle. And tried to get it off, but the Berwick player came in and just stuffed it.
Well, last week, the starters for Berwick only played one half. At this point, you might think the same thing will happen. Marshman couldn't find anybody, and he's taken down behind the line of scrimmage. That was James Hunter with the sack.
Well, that was a good play for the Dallas Mountaineers as Marshman had some time, and I thought he had a man open in the middle, but nowhere to go. He started to move forward, and he was stopped right there.
Quickly, wide on the jet sweep. Couple of yards. Third along on the way.
Yeah, wide moves to the right, but Dallas is there. Give him credit. The defense has stepped it up with him deep in Dallas territory at this time. It'll bring up about a third and 12.
Third and 12.
Well, of course, Frank Sheptock would say, I don't want any fumbles. I don't need any turnovers. Hasn't happened yet. Dallas needs one, and they almost got it.
Oh.
Almost intercepted by the safety, Charles Giacometti. That would have been huge for the Bulldogs, but fourth down on the way.
Now, does Berwick go for it here? Do you think they try for the field goal?
No, I would say Marshman has a good leg, but I think they're going to go for it, and the offense is out there already.
This is classic Berwick. The coaches may be different, but yeah, they've still got that Berwick attitude.
Marshman to the air.
Look at that.
It's what a catch by Cecini at the five. First to goal, Bulldogs.
And that's what I mean by that Berwick attitude, that fourth and 12, how many high school football teams in northeastern Pennsylvania are going to come up with a play like that and make it, and then the individual effort of catching the ball while you're in the air and come down on your back. Look at this. What a catch.
Talked about Cecini early on the player impact. Wida, touchdown Bulldogs. Three possessions, three scores, and the Bulldogs are blowing this one out early.
Well, Len Wida, this is simple compared to the play before.
Kenny Marshman will attempt the point after.
And the Berwick band playing a happy tune here this evening as the Bulldogs looking to make it 21-0 with this extra point.
Marshman's kick is up and through. 21-0, Bulldogs, 3:28 in the first quarter.
Let's take a look at that run by Wider in the into the end zone. The Bulldogs, well, here's the play before, and this is what I mean by the attitude of the Berwick Bulldogs. Look at that catch. Comes down on his back, and then from there, yeah, you make that play, and then first and goal from the 4-yard line. Well, that's an easy play for them.
Frank Sheptock always looks like he's losing the ball game, 21-0. His team is up by three scores, and he's still pacing.
Someone must have missed a block off the play, yeah. And he's not happy about it.
Well, he told an interview this week, from week one to two, you see the biggest improvement. They looked pretty good in week one, Joe.
Yeah.
And they looked improved today.
Well, I don't know how you can play much better. Coaches will say, well, yeah, we did this wrong, we did that wrong. But from a layman's eye, that's a perfect football. This is a perfect quarter that they've played.
Dallas, meanwhile, would like to start this one over. How about Schuster again, this time from the 8?
Schuster up the middle.
Breaks out. Got some running room. So, if anything, Dallas will start with good field position at the 45.
Well, that is what the Mountaineers needed. Something at least to smile about. Something at least to look at during the week and say, hey, we did well on this. And talking with Coach Rich Minnello this week, the special teams is something that he is totally into, and he works on that.
Well, we talked about early on that left side of the Dallas offense against Monaco and Struthers, and that's one of our impact players, and it's going to be impacted right here. They go off the left side. It's Hutchins, just a couple.
But at least it's something positive for the Dallas Mountaineers. They're not stuffed up on the line of scrimmage. They at least got some positive yards, 3 yards by Hutchins, and it brings up a second and seven.
Dallas in search of their first down of the game, and we're already almost 11 minutes in. Nothing fancy about this Dallas offense. Ground and pound. Let's see if they go to the option. He's straight ahead again to Hutchins. I think he got to midfield barely.
Hutchins got to midfield, but that was about it before he got wrapped up in the arms of that big junior, Chase Struthers.
Third and five.
Look, he goes right up the middle. Watch big number 70 right there. Comes off the block. Oh, it was Evan Klinger who got him first. Smothers just fell on him at the end.
He smothered him.
Gave him the business.
Here goes Dallas again. Still looking for their second completion. Minnello trying to get a first down. He's going to be short, so what does Rich Minnello do? They're inside Bulldog territory, 2 yards to go. Fourth down on the way, Joe. Do you do?
You know what? It's not my job. It's Rich Minnello's job. But if it were me, I'd probably gamble for it.
You're down 21-0 at this point. Yeah. You have nothing to lose.
It's fourth and two. And we'll see. You know, and this is the difference between the two teams. Fourth and 12, down at the other end. No biggie. Fourth and two. Let's see if Dallas can.
Here comes the blitz. Straight up the left side. Hutchins. He'll have a first down. Couple more.
Good job by Hutchins. Keeps those legs moving as he keeps going off to the left side. Bounces off one tackle. Gets the first down. And they can. It's about 4 yards more. Watch this. Hutchins comes out there. Bounces off that man. Gets away from him and picks up, gets across the 40.
Nice block by the freshman, Taylor Ballesta, number 41 out of the fullback position. We haven't seen the option run yet, though. Let's see if they go to that. Hutchins looked like he bobbled that a little bit, but he picked up a couple yards.
And there's the Dallas brain trust trying to get something going here. They've got their first down. They are as far as they've been all night into Berwick territory. This is the first time, as a matter of fact, that they're in Berwick territory.
And it's the first time they can actually take time off the clock.
Yes.
Hutchins puts his head down again, up to the 35. Joe, last week he carried 32 times. I'm sure he took an ice bath last week, and he's going to get a lot of the carries tonight as well.
Yeah, and I would keep giving it to him, watching him run right here. Look it. He takes a hit there, keeps going, keeps those legs moving, and gets across the 35-yard line. Well, the ball is on the 35, but he looks good.
So that will do it. Dallas is happy. This first quarter is over, but it's been all Berwick Bulldogs here tonight in the Back Mountain. 3 touchdowns, and they lead 21-0.
Looking for the right direction when buying your new Chevrolet? Let Lila point the way to Sylvester Chevrolet in Peckville. Whether it's the all-new Chevy Cruze or the stylish Malibu, trust the Sylvester Chevrolet sales team for the best prices around. And for service after the sale, you can count on the highly trained technicians and the friendly parts department. The Sylvester family has been in business for 44 years. They know how to treat you like one of their own. Find new roads. Sylvester Chevrolet in Peckville, 3 miles off I-81, exit 190.
Are you ready? I'm ready to learn the skills that lead to a career, not just a job. I'm ready to earn a degree, not a lot of debt.
I'm ready for a powerful degree that will transfer to other colleges and universities. My mind is ready. I'm ready for Luzerne County Community College.
We are back in the Back Mountain. A beautiful night for a high school football at Mountaineer Stadium. Bob I, Joe Thomas, Aaron Dugan. We're watching the Berwick Bulldogs put a little bit of a clinic on against the Dallas Mountaineers. But Dallas right now, Joe, at least on the move inside Bulldog territory.
Well, Dallas is in Bulldog territory, but right now they're back to where they were earlier in the first quarter, and that's 4th and 6 after that play really went nowhere. They lost a yard on that play.
Coach Manello will play the field position game. He will send his punter in. And Anderson with the kick, trying to get it inside the 5, almost. Oh. Touchback for Dallas.
Not a bad effort. The ball, unfortunately for Dallas, took a bounce to the left instead of taking a bounce to the right near the sidelines. And that'll bring up Berwick's 4th position in their worst field position of the night at their own 20-yard line.
Yeah, how about that? It's their own 20-yard line.
Yeah. Might as well make them work a little bit, you know?
At least let them try. So here come the Bulldogs back on the field. Marshman with a touchdown through the air already. Wida a couple on the ground. He has the ball and more. Picks up a block. Wida up to the 47-yard line. 27 yards.
And a touchdown-saving tackle right there.
Play is good for Berwick. First
down. I don't know if that was Hunter. Take a look at this Wida. Wida moves out to the left. And then he turns on the speed. That was, what, Giacometti?
Yep. Here's Wida again. Back into the secondary, and Giacometti makes the play again, this time at the Dallas 31.
And starting at their own 20-yard line already, the Berwick Bulldogs are in Dallas territory at the Mountaineers 34. Look at this.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs from the Dallas.
What do you like about Wida already, what you've seen?
Quick. And he's got jittery moves. I like that.
So, again, this time it's their backup. Klinger gets a shot. Just a couple yards. Second down.
Klinger, the ball cast. Brought down by number 13, David Schuster.
Take a look at this. This time they give it to Klinger, and Klinger is stopped early on after maybe a yard or two. A nice tackle there by the Dallas defense. Number 13, David Schuster.
Klinger left side. Near a Berwick first down, knocked out of bounds at the 25.
Marshman on the keeper, brought down by number 8, Charles Giacometti.
Dallas defense has been on the field a long time. They have a lot of players going both ways, Joe,
yeah.
And they already have their hands on their hips.
First and 10 for the
Bulldogs. Yeah, going both ways. It's tough. Berwick's only got 2 players that go both ways. So basically, they're staying fresh. Here goes Wida again. And Wida gets down to the 15.
He is shifty. Pickup of 8. They started this drive, as Joe mentioned, at their own 20.
And here it is. Wida, look at him. He finds those holes. Doesn't look like there's much there, but he gets there. There he is again.
He's Wida. He loses the ball, and Dallas gets a break, and they recover it in the end zone. So Berwick was about to put another touchdown on the board. They knock it free, and Dallas recovers.
Well, there's a Dallas Angel somewhere down near the end zone because he came up and knocked it out. Or that Angel might have been number 26, Leonard Kelly. He was the Angel, but... And the referees Yeah, put it on the 20, guys.
Boy, what a break there. You saw the freshman Kelly get a hand in there. So now Dallas needs to get a sustained drive and get some points on the board.
Dallas gets their first break of the evening. Let's see if they can capitalize.
Hutchins, stop, go, and then nailed.
He ran about 15 yards to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Aaron is down in the crazy section of Dallas. What do you got there, Aaron?
Bob, every single week at these games, I lose a little bit more of my hearing. So that's okay. This is so much fun. They're down by a couple touchdowns. They are having a blast. I'm here with Carly. Tell me about your student section.
We're just here to have some fun tonight. We're here to support our team. We love to have, we have new themes every week. And today, we actually had a cookout today with hot dogs and stuff. And we get to have some fun.
Theme come from the Olympics?
Yeah, we were pumped that the USA won, killed it at the Olympics, and we love our country, so we wanted to show it. So
I know you're a senior and you're really proud and you're really excited to get this last year out of the way, aren't you?
Yes, exactly. I've been here for 4 years now, and it's so exciting to be at the front and running everything. So we're having a good time and we're trying to make it the best we can.
Yeah, you guys are definitely having a blast. You want to throw it back to Bob?
Joe's up here chanting, USA, wow. USA. And he's getting into it.
Impressed. It only took her 4 years to get out of high school.
That's amazing. So third down on the way and long. Manello throws it out of bounds. And Dallas will be forced to punt, and that Berwick defense has been stingy.
There's a lot of young players on this Dallas squad, and they're playing freshmen. And one of the things that Coach Manello was talking about was getting some of these freshmen and sophomore quality time in games. Now, it might not help them this year, but as the years progress and they become sophomores and juniors, then seniors, they're going to have a ton of experience under their helmets.
Michael Anderson had his last punt blocked. This one is a high hanger. And something, there's Coach Sheptock's going to say something about that. You know, he's going to say, let the ball go, guys.
Yeah.
Damon Beckhorn picked it up.
Let's see if the coach says anything to him.
Hey, you're up 21-0.
Yeah, the coach was nice about it.
He was.
Don't do that again. And tapped him on the head.
Wait to the film room next on Monday. So, 8:20 remaining in the second quarter. Three touchdowns put up by the Bulldogs in the first, and that's where we stand right now, 21-0. Jarrett Marshman, number 9. The 6'1 junior getting the start has looked impressive, and second flag of the night comes in.
That's not bad either, Bob. Just two flags this evening so far for these two teams. Let's see what this one is.
Offside on the defense, number 73. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
5-yard penalty will make it first and 5.
Second time tonight, Berwick begins in Dallas territory. Marshman back. Gets it out to his swing man. This is Force, and Force gets about 15.
Boy, watching that play. Marshman, yeah, he got some pressure in the backfield, and Force was just sitting out there. Watch this. Force, you'll see him there at the 50. He's just standing out there wide open. A great safety valve for Marshman.
Wide of scoots through for a couple.
Number 5, Len Wide of the ball carrier.
Really impressed with the offensive line. They do have a couple of injuries. Woodard's out with an injury. Kyle Roberts, mostly a fullback, suits up, changes numbers. Wouldn't know the difference at that right tackle position.
Well, and that's a philosophy both of these coaches have. We're going to talk about that in a second. And they've got a name for it.
Marshman to the air. He's got a guy.
Oh, what a catch.
Matt Champ with a circus catch in the end zone. Touchdown, Berwick.
Matt Champ. boy, oh boy, the second great catch. First it was Cassini, and then it was Champ, now Champ. And what a catch for a touchdown. A one-hander. An ode to Odell Beckham. Here we go. Look at the throw. One hand.
What a catch, 32 yards. Different angle. Same results. Berwick adds another one. Here's Marshman on for the extra point. It is up and through. So touchdown, Berwick, 28-0. It's been all dogs here tonight in the Back Mountain. But we come back, can Dallas get anything on the board?
You're watching the Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY.
Here you go.
Our dog is gonna love camping with this.
Come on, get in!
Eric!
Come on, let's do it again, ready?
My turn.
Now get a new 2016 RAV4 with $1,250 total cash back. Or pick no interest financing for 60 months. Plus, get $500 bonus cash. Toyota, let's go places.
Learn to see.
Learn to speak.
B-b-bail.
Awesome.
Learn to solve. Ready to inject the sample?
Learn the balance. Nice.
Learn to fly.
Well, they're a happy bunch of girls there. Bye-bye, Joe Thomas, Aaron Dugan. We're at Mountaineer Stadium. It's been all Berwick, as you might expect, 28-0. And, Joe, if you're Dallas, you got to take the positive out of something, win the little battles.
Yeah, and right now they're starting at their own 20 after the touchback on the kickoff. And a little battle might be a first down, plain and simple.
Manello rushed, and they say he will be sacked by Klinger.
Wow. Well, either way, either if he gets the intentional grounding or he gets sacked, he's going to lose yardage.
How about the speed on Klinger?
Yeah. I think his knees were down by the time he threw the ball out. So
the ball is back at the 13-yard line. Rich Manello talked about getting his youth involved, Joe, and you know, these are called growing pains.
Yes, and it's his second year. This area has known winning teams over the years, and I don't think it might be the most patient area for a rebuilding type program. So there might be, you know, some problems, but Manello, talking to him this week, he has got a plan. He's got the mini football leagues around here in the Back Mountain, the Raiders and the Hawks, and he has got them on board, and he got them to stop playing their A teams, which are seventh graders. He's having them play in the junior high to get a little more experience with him.
Third and long. Manello trying to look for anything downfield, but too many people out there.
Wow.
Hits someone.
That was a dangerous pass. He gets back just maybe a yard ahead of the original line of scrimmage. So
Chris Murray on the catch found some space, but fourth down away, and Dallas will have to punt.
You wonder if maybe he should have run, and this is a dangerous pass thrown against the grain, thrown across the field. But it worked out for them that time, in as much as it wasn't intercepted.
So Berwick will again have good field position to work with. It's Beckhorn. Up inside the 40 to the 39, and that's where the Dogs will begin. They scored on almost every possession except one so far, Joe, and that was a fumble in the end zone.
Just think, it could be 35-0 right now.
Bulldogs will take over.
Well, I think most people, the experts, let's say, Joe, had it a little closer than this. When you and I talked, we knew this could happen.
Yeah. Yeah, we were talking about that earlier this week, Bob. It could get ugly.
And it's because it's a young Dallas team. It was nothing against the Mountaineers. It was just
flags on the field.
It's men against boys.
That's the truth.
So another flag. Here's our flag. Third down. Third one of the game.
Defense. 73. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Second time Dallas has been offsides.
Beckhorn came off the field with a little limp if you saw him a few moments ago. I wonder if we'll see him later on this evening. Because we're going to see a lot of players that we're not sure of.
Reverse. This is Force. He can throw the ball. He looked for Marshman back the other way.
Oh!
Marshman puts a huge block. Flag goes down as Force is forced out of bounds. But everyone in the stadium is looking at that block by Marshman. And he took out James Hunter.
Man, when things fall apart for Berwick, all of a sudden, they're able to make chicken salad out of... Watch this. Horse can throw it. He comes across. And Marshman. Boom! Oh! Quarterbacks aren't supposed to throw blocks like that.
Well, we had a penalty as Force went down. The ball's at the 24, I believe. And now they're going to mark it back. Let's see what Patrick Will has to say.
That block was one for the end of the year highlight reels.
It looks like it will be against Berwick.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness on the offense. Illegal blindside block, 15 yards, it'll be first down.
I think that was downfield as he went out of bounds.
All right, you don't think that was against Marshman?
No, I think that was a legal block.
Yeah. Well.
The penalty was inside the 30, so the ball's now just outside of the 40 at the 41. Trying to get a check on the down marker now as the referees will talk to Coach Frank Sheptock. I don't know if we can see that play again in its entirety, you guys.
Here we go.
We'll try to let it play through.
He wasn't looking at him.
No, I think that's a legal block. It might be right. They threw it down behind the play. So you can see the flag coming in at the lower end of the screen. So whatever it was in the middle of the field. Couldn't see who it was on. So it is first down. The ball is at the 41-yard line. Berwick gets to play again. They give it a wide short through.
And he gets down to about the 36-yard line. So Berwick has a little bit of adversity against them, and we'll see how they bounce back from it. But boy, that was a block.
That's a stinger block. You're going to feel that if you're Hunter. The play legally didn't count. Set up a screen. Wide, what a play on the outside.
Nice open field tackle there.
That was number two, Chris Murray, the junior.
And you hear, when Bob's calling the plays, a junior here, a freshman here, a sophomore, a couple of seniors, but the junior makes the play there, Chris Murray.
Marshman surveying. That's plenty of time. Farrell comes in, and Marshman threw it away with his left hand.
Well, that was a good play by Marshman to get it away because Farrell had them all wrapped up. This is the kid that Division I schools are looking at. Watch him come through here. And he's got some speed, so as he chases Marshman, he catches him. And Marshman, the heads-up play to get it incomplete pass to Frank Sheptock.
Well, Sheptock was a linebacker.
Yeah, so he's got no hands.
No, zero hands. He can make tackles. We have a timeout on the field. So we'll stay right here. I believe that's called by Berwick because it's fourth down on the way.
Now, some of these freshmen on the Dallas squad, talking with Coach Manello this week, some of these freshmen are going to be playing tomorrow down at Crispin Field because they've got a junior high game. Or maybe it's Monday, I'm sorry. But they're going to play tonight, and then they're going to play on Monday also. So, yeah, they're getting a lot of football knowledge. The two big games in less than a week. And as Coach Manello figures, that's only going to help them in the future. Playing all this Dallas football, they're going to get it. And eventually, these kids are going to turn into stars up here on the back mountain.
Dallas does have a rich history. They did win the 1993 state championship in AA. Ted Jackson was the coach.
So here you go. It's a fourth down, Bob. Fourth and five. And Berwick's going for it. You know, maybe they're going to try and draw Dallas offsides.
Marshman is going to survey the field. And he had a receiver. That was Champ. I guess he can't use two hands. He needs to use one.
Yeah.
But it goes incomplete. Dallas takes over on downs.
And so, you know, you talked about winning little battles for the Dallas Mountaineers. Right there was a little battle. And they won that one. Now, let's add on to something here. 3:34 left here in the first half. Let's see if they could put a first down or a couple first downs together.
Well, you know what Rich Manello will not do? He will not abandon the run.
No.
This is not an offense built to come back quickly. As they say that, Manello throws it. Oh, bobbled and caught. There's a break for Dallas.
Like we were saying, Bob.
Yeah.
They got to go to the pass.
Just like you drew it up, Ed Sikowski, the junior, with a big catch.
And there's another little battle that's won. A little pinball action here. But the ball didn't hit the ground. You keep following that ball. They call it the tip drill. And there it did. There it went. It paid off for the Mountaineers.
16 yards through the air inside Bulldog territory for Dallas. Manello with some room. Picks up nice yardage up to about the 38.
There you go. Shake it up a little bit. Have your quarterback go through there. He's got some speed on him. And pick up of about 7 yards there on the play.
Yeah, up to the 41.
Here you go. And he just goes straight up the middle, nothing fancy. And they're just changing things up a little bit here. Ooh.
Hutchins caught it, but he was belted by Klinger quickly. No gain on the play.
I give the kid credit for hanging onto the ball because that was right there. That hit was right there as soon as he caught it.
Dallas now going to the hurry-up offense. Manello, short to Murray. Probably lost a yard. So you see what Dallas is able to do. Some easy outs, Joe, and really they lost a yard, fourth down on the way.
Berwick's with some good open field tackle out there. Justin Groshek in on that one. And it brings up a fourth down. Another punting situation for Dallas, but they were able to get a first down. They were able to get some yards after that first down. Little victories.
Beckhorn and Klinger back to receive the punt for the Bulldogs. Anderson will have a sore leg tomorrow. Fouled a bit by Clear. Special teams right there for Dallas, and it will be Berwick ball at the 18-yard line. So things have settled down here a little bit after Berwick put up touchdowns on their first four out of five possessions.
Stop the presses. Berwick didn't score.
But there's still plenty of time left. 1:21 remaining. Two timeouts left for the Bulldogs. And we know they can do it through the air.
And up 28-0, they can work on that passing game a little.
Keep it on the ground, wide to left side. About eight on that.
And that, you know, last week, Lida averaged 9 yards a carry. So this is what Berwick has this year. And this Len Lida is a good runner. He's shifty. He stays low to the ground. Look at this.
Lida picks up a first down. Do they say he gets out of bounds?
Len Lida, the ball carrier again.
They'll move the chains. That will stop the clock momentarily.
Watch. Lida. He shifts there a little bit and is able to pick up an extra 3 yards. Even though the defender had a handful of jersey. He is quick.
He stayed in bounds. The clock starts to roll. We're under 40 seconds to play in the first half. Wide through up to the 38.
And I think Frank Sheptock has just taken time off the clock and getting them back into the locker room. Berwick will get the kickoff to start the second half.
Coach Sheptock leads the way. His team up four touchdowns on the Dallas Mountaineers as we head to the half. Coming up at the half, we'll talk to Coach Sheptock and see how the first couple of weeks are going. And we'll hear from the Mizzacorta University Athletic Director. That will be with Aaron. We're at the half here at Mountaineer Stadium. It's been all Berwick as they lead 28-0.
Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY is brought to you in part by Wendy's. Quality is our recipe. Luzerne County Community College. Einan Buick GMC. Sylvester Chevrolet. And your local Ford store. Check out every new Ford car, truck, SUV, and crossover at buyfordnow.com today.
Only Wendy's can make the Baconator. Because while some other guys use frozen beef from far away,
that's 9,429 miles away.
Wendy's only uses fresh beef from ranches close by.
So we don't have to freeze it.
Then add 6 strips of bacon, cooked fresh in an oven, never a microwave. Tossed with plenty of
cheese,
without a single veggie to get in the way.
Aww. Proving once and for all
that only Wendy's has the bacon and the ater to make the Baconator.
I buried all my whoopee cushions in the backyard.
They're Springfield's biggest family, the Simpsons,
coming to MyTV WQMY this fall.
We all have to wait. We wait at the grocery store, wait in the doctor's office, wait in traffic. But why wait if you don't have to? The Fox 56 News First at 10 gives you the news, weather, and sports first, without the wait.
Adam Cole is a brand new Ring of Honor World Champion in the Challengers of Mountain. This week on Ring of Honor Wrestling.
Saturday at 11 on CW 38. It's the Fox 56 Sports Rivalry of the Week, presented by Wendy's. This week, we head to Danville for a Heartland Conference Division II clash between the Iron Men and Montoursville. Next Friday at 7 on MyTV WQMY, your home for local sports.
Are you ready? I'm ready to learn the skills that lead to a career, not just a job. I'm ready to earn a degree, not a lot of debt. I'm ready for a powerful degree that will transfer to other colleges and universities. My mind is ready. I'm ready for Luzerne County Community College.
Coming up Saturday, the Liberty Flame head to Blacksburg to take on the Virginia Tech Hokies.
Saturday at noon on MyTV, WQMY.
Come on, we're going to run the bubble. Go on. Yeah, oh, that's perfect there. Perfect. Dane has a TFL. You make a great play. Here we go. Right here.
If you're a Wilkes University football fan, then his voice sounds very familiar. For 18 years, Frank Sheptock led the Colonels on the sidelines. The one-time Bloomsburg Husky All-American linebacker left Wilkes 2 years ago to become Berwick's high school athletic director. When longtime coach George Curry passed away this year, the district didn't have to look very far to find a new coach.
Well, very exciting. Obviously, you come to a program like Berwick where there's great tradition. Obviously, there's a lot of expectation. And obviously, the boys, football is very important to them. Football is very important to the community. So it's an outstanding opportunity for me. So, I love to coach, love being back around the team and being in the locker room and building relationships. So, it's off to a great start. Look forward to the season.
Yeah, so, obviously Coach Curry was a legend, and there's no topping that. He was, a father figure to many and a great football coach. But the one attribute that Coach Curry and Coach Sheptock really share is that, winning's not an option. It's a lifestyle. So that's the one thing that he's really instilled in us, and we're excited to play for the guy. We all bought in, and we're excited.
Understand? Move out a little bit, Michael. Okay? You're going to turn this way. You're going all the way around to him. Okay? You're doing that. Here we go.
Left.
This is right. Sal's the center. Here we go. When I drop my hand.
Pull.
Yeah. Very good.
When Sheptock was offered a chance to coach high school football, something he's never done before, he first went to an old friend who made the transition himself.
Richie and I were at Kings. That friendship, forged, and it's extremely strong. The first day after he got the job at Dallas, he was down with me at Berwick because I'm getting ready for the Berwick job. I'm on the phone with him, saying, what do I need to do with this and do with that, and, helping each other prepare. So, I think it's a type of situation, Bob, where, obviously that's someone you're extremely close to. It's like when you're, competing against someone you're really close to, you're trying to, do the best you can, and you want to impress that person, and, they mean a lot to you, so you want to do your best. And
yeah, I actually talked to him one day, and I said, listen, if this, situation comes around at some point in your life, you gotta take a look at it, because in reality, it's actually more football than what we did, because, most of the year was spent recruiting in college. We became very close over the years. We were a block away from each other, and in a 20-year span, there was never even a rumor of negative recruiting between the two places, and that's rare. We really believe in the same fundamental philosophies of football. We're going to block and tackle and get after it in the C gap on both sides of the ball. But we've become very good friends, and that friendship means an awful lot to me, and I know he feels the same way.
The one thing you'll notice when you come to a Berwick practice is just the similarity between George Curry and Frank Sheptock. They run practices with high intensity, a lot of detail, and boy, do they love the game.
Here we go. Remember, we want it to go opposite of where it wants to go.
With a solid senior class and talent all around, Berwick will be one of the favorites in the new 4A class in District 2.
Well, I definitely believe that sets the tone really for any football type program where you have to be strong up front and you have to have some experience. If we stay healthy, we could have seniors at every position. Obviously, there's some health things that we got to be able to work through and things like that, but we have a tremendous amount of experience. We have some size there, and then we have some depth from some young men who got experience, because last year is Coach battled some of the things from an injury bug standpoint that some other young men got experience. So I believe on the offensive and defensive lines that if we can be a dominant presence on both sides of the ball, that gives us the best opportunity to be successful.
I'm excited. It's nothing but excitement. You know, you grow up with these kids playing in BYFL, you know, like my friends, Kyle Roberts, Ansassini, Lenny Wada, Justin Grosch, Kyle Pitt. You know, like, there's just such a combined class, and it's nothing but excitement coming into it, and I know collectively that's just, we're all excited.
How well Berwick ends up the regular season will depend on weeks 8, 9, and 10 when they face off against Wyoming Valley West, Lake Lehman, and Williamsport.
Welcome back to Mountaineer Stadium. You're watching live high school football on MyTV, WQMY. It's Berwick 28, Dallas 0 at the half. I'm Erin Dugan. We thank you so much for joining us tonight. We have a special guest joining us now. This is Chuck Edkins, the athletic director at Misericordia University. Thanks so much for coming down the street to chat with us.
It's great. Thanks for having me, Erin. Good to see you.
So speaking of right down the street, do you get a lot of local kids in the athletic department?
We've had a number of local talent, and it's been a tremendous addition to our program. They've helped to enhance what we do. Amy Vitti, one of our cross-country track and field athletes, has had a tremendous career for us, not only athletically in terms of the number of times she's been an All-American, but she's also up for the NCAA Woman of the Year. So we're very excited about what she's done. Frankie Redmond and, you know, our head coach, Chris Wattis, from that standpoint, has had great success. He's a six-time coach of the year, local guy and from Hanover, and ran for us and has done great things.
Now let's talk a little bit of football. Tomorrow is your first game of the season. Now this is the fifth year we're now entering, so that full cycle has been run through. What have you seen from that progress, and what's the general consensus?
Yeah, we're very pleased. Mark Ross has done a tremendous job, our head coach, and he really teaches these young men everything that Division III athletics and football is about. We have continued to be competitive and successful, but I think one of the things that was a great tribute to us, when we had Senior Day last year, we marched 24 seniors out of a first year that we started with about 90, ended up with a roster about 62. 24 of those young men stayed with it from start to finish. And our opponent that day had come up and said to me, one of their administrators said, Coach, I'm not sure we've ever had 15 seniors at the end of 4 years. So what they have done has been tremendous. Mark's leadership is great. And these guys understand that they're representing Misericordia both on and off the field.
So they're ready for the season tomorrow?
Yeah, we're ready. We're excited. Utica's a good program. Very competitive game at their place last year. They snuck on us, but we'll see if we can take care of business tomorrow.
Well, I wouldn't let you go without talking soccer. We have to talk soccer. You're the former soccer coach, and man, how much success the teams have had. Just talk us through that a little bit.
Yeah, it's been great. The men's program has had very good success both at the regional and national level. Our women's program, under the direction of Mark Stauffer, we've been to the Final Four in 2012, a number of Sweet 16 appearances. Field hockey, Robin Fedor Stahovic, who is a local product and played for us, won her first conference championship last year, took us to the NCAA tournament, and as we mentioned, cross country as well. Volleyball, they're up at the Cortland tournament this weekend, so a lot of excitement on campus and off campus as well, but a lot of success because of the types of young men and women that come to our program and are doing very, very well in the classroom as well in their competitive sport.
Definitely. What would you say to a prospective student maybe wanting to check things out, come up and check the athletic department out?
Yeah, I think one of the things is everyone's looking for the right fit, but I think our campus is really second to none. It's a beautiful campus. We have a great faculty to student ratio, small. There's a lot of individual attention for you there, and we really care about each student as a person first and foremost. And I think that's one of the things that has really been, it makes us proud, you know, and just an example, about 40% of the students on our campus are varsity athletes. Last year we had 508 student athletes and our GPA was a 3.34 overall. So we're able to balance it. We have a lot of activities outside of athletics also for people to get involved with, but the people really make it the difference at Misericordia. It's something we call the Misericordia Mystique. It's pretty cool. You get on campus. You
get that on a shirt.
Yeah, not bad at all. So.
All right, Chuck, thank you so much for stopping to chat with us.
My pleasure. Thanks, Erin.
All right, we'll be back with highlights from the first half. When we come right back, you're watching live high school football on MyTV, WQMY.
What's in the name?
Kindly hold, Simpson.
What's going on?
Are you screaming?
So if you see the Simpsons walking down your street, lock your doors and hide.
Hey, hey!
How did I get here? Here's $50. For the next 2 hours, I don't want to know you exist.
Thank you. Come again.
What's in the name? Pretty much everything. The Simpsons. Coming to MyTV WQMY this fall.
When there's news. There is Fox 56 News first at 10. Get the news and weather that matters to you most right at 10 p.m.
Learn to see.
Learn to speak.
B-b-bail.
Awesome.
Learn to solve. Ready to inject the sample?
Learn the balance.
Nice.
Learn to fly.
There is a brand new Ring of Honor world champion. Adam Cole is now a two-time ROH champion, and the challenges are mounting. Plus, in the main event, Leo Rush and Jay White face ROH legends Jay and Mark Briscoe.
Saturday at 11 on CW 38, WSWB.
It's a great night for high school football in the Back Mountain. Fans filing in from both sides into Mountaineer Stadium being greeted by the Dallas cheerleaders, and we're at the half. The score 28-0. Inside the booth now, Bob Eide and Joe Thomas here. And Joe, we thought it could happen. Berwick has put on a show tonight. They lead by four touchdowns.
We didn't want to say that dirty five-letter word.
Yeah.
I think it's five letters.
Which one?
Mercy.
Mercy. It's five letters.
It's five letters.
Yeah, we're one touchdown short of a mercy rule.
One touchdown short. So we're going to see if Dallas can keep this one going a little bit longer here. Berwick's going to get the ball to start the second half. And, boy, oh, boy, they came out guns a-blazing in the first half. After Dallas took the ball, they won the toss, received three and out, and then the Berwick offense just took over.
Let's take a look at the first half highlights. And it was the first play of the game, and it was the Berwick Bulldogs, and it was Marshman to Champ.
Yeah, Champ comes out here, makes the catch, and then it's just off to the races for him.
Champ, two catches, 95 yards.
But that was not even close to the best catch of the night. There you go, Len Wida. And Wida once again bulls his way in.
Second quarter was much of the same. It was all Berwick, and it was Wida.
Look at him, bouncing off guys, getting down. In there, boom. And that was perhaps the most fortuitous play of the night. But then look at this, as we said.
Wida, Champ with the big one-handed catch. It made it a touchdown, and that's where we stand, 28-0. Champ, two catches, 95 yards, and two touchdowns. Wida on the ground, 15 carries, 124 yards. In all, Berwick has 275 yards of total offense to Dallas's 56.
Yeah, and, you know, the game's probably over. You know, I don't think any coach would say it is, you know, the way the coaches are. But this is a chance, the second half, for Coach Minella to work on some of the younger guys, get them in, give them a little bit of action, and see what happens.
Well, Berwick is on the field. Coach Sheptock took them in pretty quick, so let's see what he had to say. Aaron will talk to him, but we'll take a quick timeout here. 28-0, third quarter on the way here from Mountaineer Stadium in Dallas. You're good.
You're watching the Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY.
Here come the last of the 2016s.
I love this part. Stylish Prius, sporty Camry, fun Corolla, adventurous RAV4, they're all here. But not for long.
Now, get a new Camry with $3,000 cash back from Toyota. Or buy with no interest financing for 72 months, plus up to $1,500 in additional savings.
Come in and get the 2016 Toyota you want before they are going gone.
Toyota, let's go places.
What's in a name?
I diddly hoax, Simpsons.
Pretty much everything.
The Simpsons. Coming to MyTV WQMY this fall.
When there's news. There is Fox 56 News first at 10. Get the news and weather that matters to you most right at 10 p.m. with Fox 56 News first at 10.
Coming up Saturday, the Liberty Flame head to Blacksburg to take on the Virginia Tech Hokies.
Saturday at noon on MyTV WQMY.
It's the Fox 56 Sports Rivalry of the Week presented by Wendy's.
This week, we head to Danville for a Heartland Conference Division II clash between the Ironmen and Montoursville. Next Friday at 7 on MyTV WQMY, your home for local sports.
The key to getting your message out there. If you advertise on television, you know what these businesses already know. Television brings your story to life with exquisite video production, targeted script writing, precision editing, which adds up to one creative commercial spot that will get people to call, click, and visit.
I love it.
Get your business off the ground with the Fox 56 production team and put your ad here.
Pitch, a new series.
Coming this fall to Fox 56.
Frank Sheptock's team has things going their way. Up 4 touchdowns over his friend and rival, Rich Manillo, and the Dallas Mountaineers. Bye-bye, Joe Thomas and Aaron Dugan back at Mountaineer Stadium. A couple quick scores, a couple of upsets happening around District 2. Hazleton at the half leads Valley West 15-0.
Wow.
That's a huge one. Pittston over Tunkhannock. Wyoming area, who Berwick will face next week, leads Crestwood 12-7. Northwest is beating Lake Lehman at the half 12-6. And how about this one? At the half, Carbondale and Old Forge are tied at 14.
Now, Bob, last week, Berwick demolished Hazleton 40-0. Wyoming area is supposed to be perhaps the best team in the area.
One of
the best teams in the area. And now the team that was demolished 40-0 is beating them at the half.
Is beating
it's only at the half.
Valley West.
Only
time.
At the half.
Yep.
I understand, but wow. What does that say about these Bulldogs?
I think they're very good.
Number 84, Nathan Moran.
And I think when we talk about preseason predictions, they're just preseason.
Yeah. You can guess, but you don't know. Especially in high school. You could have pretty educated guesses in college and even more so in the pros.
Moransky tees it up, and he boots this one down to the end zone. It will be a touchback. So Berwick will start on their own 20-yard line, and Aaron Dugan's down, and she had a chance to talk to Coach Rich Manillo. Aaron?
I did, Bob. I chatted with Coach Manillo coming out of the locker room. I asked him about any words of encouragement he may have given the team, and he said that he told them that they just had to come together and band together around some of those younger kids that are showing a little bit of inexperience out there. He also said they're getting out-hit, and that's got to change, but he really stressed banding around those younger kids and staying the course.
Rich Manillo, 6-6 overall here at Dallas, his second season. So Marshman continues to be the quarterback. And this one gets tipped right into Cicini's hands, and he's down to the 41.
That should have been an interception by the Dallas Mountaineers, and that's got to frost Rich Manillo a little bit. Here. Who was it? Right through his hands. Boom! Number 2, Chris Murray. He'll be having dreams about that tonight. Nightmares.
Yeah, Murray, a junior. Back to Klinger. He gets a start here in the second half.
Getting back to what Aaron said about Coach Manillo and what he talked about, we're getting out hit. I think he can live with being outskilled. But being out hit and being pushed around, I don't think he'll take too kindly to that.
I'm sure this is the calmer, gentler Rich Manillo now. It's not the coach we saw when he first came to Kings.
On wide of the ball carrier, brought down by number 13, David Schuster.
Schuster with the tackle there for the Dallas Mountaineers.
Third and 4.
Marshman hands off to Wida. Schuster with a good play, a nice tackle as Wida is in the air. Getting back to Manillo. His first day at Kings back in 1990. He came on my radio show that night. I was ready to go back to school, recruit and play for it.
So a big third down. Marshman will go to the air, and oh, that was almost picked off again by Murray. And if he caught it, he was gone.
Number 6, by fourth, broken up by number two, Chris Murray.
Yeah, that was
fourth and four.
That was one that he'll be thinking about later on. This could have been six. Could have been a pick six for him.
Nice read on the play. So
Jared Marshman in punt formation.
Marshman is in punt formation.
He might need to get some of those receivers close.
Oh, a lot of movement up front. And if this is Dallas who moved, it will be a Berwick first down. Again, our referee, Patrick Will, out of the Wyoming Valley Conference.
Offside, defense, 43, 5-yard penalty.
I saw something written this week where George Curry left all his playbooks for Frank Sheptock after the end. That's been in Berwick's playbook for as long as I can remember watching them, 30 years, having the other team be forced offsides and getting them a first down on special teams.
Well, it worked to perfection, and you know George Curry's overhead watching this one.
Wider powers his way for about 3 yards there. And that's what Berwick's been doing all night, powering their way. I mean, these kids have got moves, but hey, they are just as well run behind their line and have their line push and beat people up.
See, that's a youthful offsides.
Yeah.
And that's what Rich Manella will say. This is what we're learning. Wida scoots through up to the past the 40, close to another first down.
Boy, he sees those openings, and those openings might be only 3 feet above the field, but he can bend down and keep that speed going.
Wida in that first half, Joe, 124 yards on the ground.
Yeah, you're number one, all right.
There's the Bulldog. Now, I don't know if the real Bulldog made it. Now, if you're at Crispin Field, you have the real one. Here's a little reverse to Force. They almost got him in the backfield.
Yeah.
Force putting some moves on up to the 20.
Marshman also almost clipped right there. He was lucky not to get called on that one. He was just in front of the defender.
Plays good for a Berwick first down.
And that was one of the plays deeper in the playbook that they've worked that they'll work on here in the second half.
So we're at the 22. Bulldogs on the move again to begin this third quarter.
Wida cuts out to the right.
Well, Wida.
Look at that.
Showing moves and showing power inside the 10. First and goal, Berwick.
Len Wida, we see why he gained so many yards last week. He's doing the same thing here tonight.
Plays good for a Berwick first down.
And he just got this ball, went right, and just kept moving, breaking tackles, demoralizing the Dallas Mountaineers.
Wida already with a couple of touchdowns and in making number three.
Len Wida. Puts it up, puts Berwick up 34-0 here in the third quarter. And
an 80-yard drive helped by a penalty on Dallas on the offsides on what could have been a fourth down punt.
This time Wida comes to the left and then just puts his shoulder down at the end zone line and just powers his way in.
Ken Marshman. Hope Sheptock looking on. Kick is up, and it is through. So with 9:12 remaining in the third quarter, Berwick extends their lead to 35-0 with an impressive drive here on my TV.
What's in the name?
Hi, diddly ho, Simpsons.
What's going on?
Ah! You snipe me!
Pretty much everything. The Simpsons, coming to MyTV WQMY this fall.
Don't feel like waiting for the late news? Fox 56 News First at 10 has what you're looking for now, so you don't have to wait. A full hour newscast, a full hour earlier, first to wrap up the day's events, first with your forecast, and a full hour earlier. Fox 56 News First at 10, where the news comes first. Montoursville battles Danville next Friday at 7 on MyTV WQMY.
Adam Cole is a brand new Ring of Honor world champion, and the challenges are mounting this week on Ring of Honor Wrestling.
Saturday at 11 on CW38.
Coming up Saturday, the Liberty Flame head to Blacksburg to take on the Virginia Tech Hokies.
Saturday at noon on MyTV WQMY.
The Eagles are headed to the Miller Symphony Hall in Allentown September 13th for a spotlight forum featuring safety Malcolm Jenkins and alumni Ryan Westbrook, Mike Quick, and Barrett Brooks. Tickets include an autographed Malcolm Jenkins poster, fan Q&A, and more. Fox 56 giving you three chances to win a pair of tickets. Go to our Fox 56 Facebook page to enter to win.
So Dallas took the kick. They will start right at their 20-yard line, as Berwick took only nine plays to go 80 yards, Joe. And we talked about those little battles that you have to win. Now you just have to battle through a 35-0 pounding by Berwick.
This is where Rich Mannello has to really earn his money and keep his team in this game as the clock keeps ticking away in a mercy rule. They've already gone to the mercy rule. This is where he has to convince them to keep playing hard.
Most impressive. Berwick hasn't let anyone score yet in six quarters this season.
Wow. Well, right there, a sack by Berwick as Mannello couldn't find anyone open. And by the time he turns back, he's buried by the Berwick defense. That was Kyle Roberts. Hand off to David Schuster.
Yep, Schuster went through, couldn't find anything. Got built it back. So third and looks like forever for Dallas. Well, one of the things Berwick talked about, and Coach Sheptock was trying not to be overconfident. I definitely don't think Berwick is overconfident at this point.
Well, you know, overconfidence, that could be taken care of in practice during the week, looking at film, finding things not to get your guys overconfident.
Next up for Dallas, they'll be at Pittston area and the Patriots, who'll be looking for their first win of the year. So Mannello had a little draw. Surprised we haven't seen more of Mannello running the ball, and I don't think we saw the option at all. When I was at practice this week, they did a simulated drive, and they ran the option three or four times.
Well, running it in practice and running it for real are two different things with the option, and you have to be 100% convinced that your kids can run it, because if you're not, it's a tough offense to run. There's a lot of mistakes that can be made. It looks basic, but it's not.
Klinger back to the 47. He's got room if he can bounce outside, and he does. Klinger down inside the 20 to the 15, and that's where the Bulldogs will be looking to put another one on the board.
And at this point, Coach Mannell might be happy that this clock keeps running.
Official timeout for an injury.
And here's the return.
We have the
I think there was an injury at the end of this play.
It might be Anderson.
Yeah.
It is.
His knee looked kind of funky as he was being brought down.
Yeah, it was Michael Anderson, but we talked about Berwick, you talked about George Curry, and of course you can't talk about the Bulldogs about talking about the old ball coach, and Aaron has four on that. Aaron?
Well, Bob, George Curry would be very proud of his dogs out here tonight, that's for sure. And before this season, the players got together. They wanted to do something for this legend, so they decided on a sticker for their helmets. As you can see right here, GC for George Curry. A lot of the players I talked with said, of course, it's like losing a father, it's like losing a legend, but they said the biggest thing is that the mentality of Berwick football is still here. It's still in their hearts. Eat, sleep, breathe football. Keep playing hard. It's all about the game, and George Curry would be very proud.
Absolutely. He knew this was coming. He knew this young Berwick team was going to be on the rise, and then, you know, he got sick, and he great effort by the team last year. We had them against Prep. Of course, they lost that game, but he got them to the district final, and they're just carrying that on.
You've been in this business a while. What was your first impression when you were first starting off?
Scared to death of George Curry.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah.
Scared to death. But once you get to know him.
Once you get to know
him. And he liked you.
Yeah.
He would really talk to you down to earth. And I'll never forget, after the Prep game, I made it a point to say goodbye to George Curry, because you kind of knew in your mind he was not doing well health-wise. Mm-hmm. So I made it to the bus, said thank you to the coach, and, you know, you have to leave that with a tear in your eye.
Well, the thing I'll remember about him, and, yeah, I was scared to death of him, but then, you know, you start working in a professional manner. I was doing the morning show with Doc on Froggy 101, and he was a big country music fan. And there was this one bit we did every day on the show, and he would talk to me about it. He goes, I listen to that before I go into Mass. He went to Mass every morning.
Every morning.
And he goes, that makes me laugh. You know, and
great.
You got a compliment from Coach Curry.
Yep.
Boy, you took it to heart.
Boy, but when his teams were winning those championships in the 90s, he was the Bulldog, and the team played like him. As Whitus scoots in from the 15 for yet another Berwick score and another score for Lenny. And this is going to just up the score into the 40s, and the clock will
continue to run.
Keep running.
Well, the Berwick Bulldogs, teams are looking at these games, Bob. Last week's game against Hazleton, look at this. Run by Wida. He didn't even have a hand on him. Not even a hand, maybe just a finger as he goes in.
Yeah, the Dallas defense has been on the field way too much tonight. Marshman, put him to the right, but it is through. And that makes the score now with 6:31 remaining in the third quarter. Berwick 42 and Dallas nothing.
42
Fox 56 Sports presents Score Stream. It's real-time high school scores plus video powered by you, the fans. Download the free app now. With Score Stream, you enter the score from the stands. Upload game video to Score Stream for other users to see. Fans, take charge with Fox 56 Sports and Score Stream. Download the free app now.
Well, there's been a lot of highlights to upload tonight for the Berwick Bulldogs as Frank Sheptock's team is pitching another shutout. And they've scored almost 86 points in two games. Next week, Wyoming Area is on the schedule, and Wyoming Area tonight leading in the third over Crestwood. Schuster from his 15, he's belted it back at the 21.
David Schuster on the return. Right now, by number 32. Joseph.
So the Dallas Mountaineers will try to put something together, and I don't know. It seems like most of the starters are still out there. At least Stone Manello is still out there.
A couple changes on the defensive front, it looks like, for Berwick. Could see a couple of the JV guys come in. We'll give their names when they make a tackle, but looks like Stone Force is in there, junior number 78. There you see 71 for Berwick. Matt Taylor, a senior. The problem is the backups for Berwick also have experience because they're very deep, and there are a lot of seniors in there too.
The thing about Berwick teams over the years, and it's been a constant, is they play a lot of players. They don't just stick with their starters. They've always rotated players in. They had one of the most complex offenses years ago, and they haven't stopped that. A lot of kids play.
Middle back. He's going to roll and keep it. I'll put to about the 28-yard line.
And with a lot of kids playing, you get your Len Widas. I mean, Wida had, 39 carries last year? Not that much, but enough to get some kind of experience. So now he's a senior, and he gets a chance to come in. We see Manolo running for a first down here. Or not a first down, for about 5 yards.
So some of the fresh players out there now for Berwick, some of their jerseys are not even dirty yet. Try to catch up to their names. Looks like the second team defense now in for the Bulldogs. Here's the blitz. Manella is going to lay it up, and it is caught. Chris Murray, the tight end, with a huge gain inside Bulldog territory. They'll place it down at the 47.
Well, I don't know if the ball was underthrown or the ball was meant to be there, but Murray sort of came back to it. It was right where he was, and he caught it falling backwards. Let's watch. And that was a nice catch by Murray.
29 yards through the air.
I think that's their biggest gain of the night.
See if Dallas can get back on the board. Get on the board for the first time. And Ellis shoots it out. Hits Motley. And he'll go out of bounds on the little out route.
Now, how much do you think Frank Sheptock wants to keep the shutout?
That's exactly what I was just thinking. He is a defensive guy.
Yeah.
He is a defensive guy. So, I don't know.
And don't think Coach Manella doesn't know that. This could be one of those little victories.
Hutchins through. Give him a couple more.
Justin Hutchins, the ball carrier.
That was a nice run, about run 6-7 yards by Hutchins. But Dallas is now moving against this second-string Berwick defense.
Knowing Coach Sheptock doesn't care about the shutout, just wants to keep people healthy. Mm-hmm. And he's getting some experience for his younger players. That's going to only help you through the season when an injury pops up. Manolo through the air, going to wing it down, almost picked
almost.
Off. In the middle, that looked like number 55, Joe Lynn, a sophomore.
Yeah.
Number 24, Christian Motley, broken up by number 55, Joseph Lynn.
Not playing like a sophomore right there. He was came right across. But he has those linebacker hands.
Designed quarterback keeper by Manello.
Looks like he
looks
got
like he
the
lost
first
the,
down.
Yeah, it looks like the ball came loose. I think they're going to call it down, though. He's up to about the 27-yard line.
I think that is going to be enough for the first down.
Joe Miller on the stop for Berwick.
Manella with a nice job here as he evades his first tackler. Look at that. He cuts back, and then he has some open field, and he keeps pushing. Stretches that ball down, but he was on the ground.
They're at the 27. Nice drive being put together by Dallas. Manello scanning, just pull it down again. He's done that several times tonight. And he's up to about the 22.
Took a hit right there, Bob. But he got about another 7 yards on that run.
And there's still a lot of games to be played in the season. As I said, Dallas will go to Pittston area.
Second,
now in 4A, as we've said previously, there's a lot of teams that make the playoffs. 8 out of 11 will make the playoffs. So it doesn't matter if you start 0-2.
It's like back in the day with the NHL. Everyone made the playoffs.
Just about. Oh, tipped at the line of scrimmage. Jimmy LeGrand.
No, his pass is in for number 24, Christian Motley.
Down in the final minute here in the third quarter. But no, there, you could get 23 or 25 teams that are going to make the playoffs in District 2.
In District 2,
it's going to be like 3 weeks of playoffs.
That's right. The 4A final will actually be in the third week. They play 3 weeks. They start with the quarters, then go to the semis before the finals are played in mid-November. To the air. Looking for Motley, knocked away. Number 27, Jacob Betts out there, another sophomore, on the coverage. So that will do it. So there's three quarters in the books as Dallas looks to snap the shutout and get some points on the board. But it's been all Berwick here tonight.
Only Wendy's can make the Baconator, because while some other guys use frozen beef from far away,
that's 9,429 miles away.
Wendy's only uses fresh beef from ranches close by,
so we don't have to freeze it.
Then add 6 strips of bacon, cooked fresh in an oven, never a microwave. Toss with plenty of
cheese,
without a single veggie to get in the way.
Aww. Proving once and for all
that only Wendy's has the bacon and the ater to make the Baconator.
Is the baseball game going to be canceled?
No, it's just a passing shower.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I saw it on the Fox 56 News.
Your Fox Weather Authority has your always changing forecast.
They built an empire on a single color.
I'm big and yellow and I'm serving yellow.
The Simpsons.
Coming to MyTV WQMY this fall. Montoursville battles Danville next Friday at 7 on MyTV WQMY.
MyTV WQMY, your regional sports leader.
NFL regular season kicks off Sunday the 11th on Fox 56. Season starts out with two big games. The Packers take on the Jaguars at 1, followed by the Giants and Cowboys at 4. Get ready for the NFL return on Sunday the 11th on Fox 56.
So fourth down on the way for Dallas. They're going to go for it, obviously. A little pitch out. And Berwick strings it out. What a fantastic play on the outside by number 86.
That's Jared Watts, a sophomore.
Brought down by number 86.
Watts stayed with his man and just gave him nowhere to go.
So the shutout remains, Joe.
Yep.
That second team defense didn't give much. Gave up a couple yards, but keeps the zero on the board. So as we talked about in the open, seems like an hour or two ago, this is a reunion of two old rivals. Rich Minnello spent 17 seasons at King's College, won the MAC championship in 2002. He did face Wilkes 17 times overall. And Berwick head coach Frank Sheptock, 18 seasons with the Colonels. Defensive coordinator before that. He was an All-American at Bloomsburg. And the big thing for Coach Sheptock, he is 10-4 against Coach Minnello.
Yep.
Now, Coach Minnello probably had the biggest win, though. His last win, 2009. Kings was definitely the underdog in that game. They came back and won. Coach Minnello resigned the next day. Went out on top. Probably of all four wins he had against Frank Sheptock, that's probably the biggest.
You do that game?
We did that game. Absolutely. It was at Kings, too. So, second team in for the Bulldogs. Number 39, Owen Shoemaker, sophomore, took the handoff.
Now, do we pick the players of the game? How does that work here, Bob?
Yeah, you can pick them. Go ahead.
I can pick them?
Yeah, go ahead. I think it's easy tonight.
I have to think.
Okay.
All right. Okay, I've thought.
I'm sure you did. Alex Force in there at quarterback number one.
You know what? I don't know if this is who you think. I'm going with Matt Champ.
Matt Champ.
Two touchdowns and the one-handed grab. Although Len White streamed it out.
I think that's easy.
Yeah.
And I think the second one's maybe the easiest of the night. I won't even bet you. Got to have a second player of the game.
Len White.
He's the first player of the game.
He's the first player of the game.
Yeah.
All right.
Big game for him overall.
Well, he was probably the player of the game last week. I don't want him to keep getting player of the game, you know?
Yep.
But he deserves it, no doubt
about
it.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I love that one-handed catch.
Number 86, Ed Sikorski, is deep for the Mountaineers.
Sikorski down for the Mountaineers at the 32. Brings it up to about the 40. Check out standings going into tonight's play and try to get maybe some scores overall. Williamsport Valley West, both at 1-0. Hazleton 0-1. And in the third quarter, Hazleton continues to beat Wyoming Valley West.
Wow.
15-6 now.
That'll knock that division up.
Yep, and Williamsport is winning their game big. So that's 6-5A, as they call it, in the new Wyoming Valley Conference. 3A and the A. This is a very competitive league. Lake Lehman, Hanover, and Holy Redeemer, and GAR, and Nanticoke, Northwest, and Myers, all 1-0. Now, GAR lost last night to Western Wayne.
Yep.
We talked about that. And Lake Lehman is losing to Northwest. And there's the 4A division. All 4A teams, I like this, because you have to play each other.
Right.
We talked about eight teams getting in. Berwick, Coughlin, Wyoming area, Tunkhannock, Crestwood, and then Dallas and Pittston area rounding it out. Coughlin gets Scranton Prep tomorrow night. Wyoming area is winning over Crestwood tonight. Tunkhannock is losing. Berwick, we could put a 2 over that,
yeah,
if we had a telestrator.
I think so.
You know, in that 4A, you think Berwick, Coughlin, Wyoming area, probably the favorites,
mm-hmm,
right there. And Wyoming area will host Berwick next week.
And this is the division, the 4A division, is the one that four teams will definitely get in. And it could be three more or
eight overall in 4A.
Okay. What we just saw was
that includes the several 4As up in the Lackawanna League. So that is going to be a very competitive division. But right now you would think Berwick is definitely the overwhelming favorite in that division. North Pocono, who plays Abington tomorrow, would be my second pick in 4A.
Dylan Schuster there with the run for the Mountaineers. Picks up 5.
Second and 4.
Picks up 6. Second and 4 for Dallas. Michael Starbuck in as the quarterback for the Mountaineers.
Right up the middle, up near the 50.
Dylan Schuster
walked
there again. So, number 51, William
Schuster. Dylan Schuster. He's just a freshman. And you mentioned they're going to have a JV game on Monday, Coach Manello said?
Yeah.
Well, see, this is basically right now the JV game.
This is it.
And they get to be on TV. It's kind of cool for them, right?
Yeah. Especially since, 70 people will be in the stands on Monday?
Well, no. Do they even have to play Monday?
Well, that's true.
Third and 2.
The left-handed Schuster wings it out. He has a receiver. That's Sibanuski. Up inside Bulldog territory to the 41.
Starbuck, the southpaw there with a nice throw.
So here's what Berwick has coming up. We mentioned Wyoming area is winning. Crestwood is losing. Sealands Grove tonight playing tough against Montoursville. Coughlin's there, Pittston area. The big game, circle that, against Valley West, and then Lake Lehman, and then Williamsport. Three very competitive games at the end of the season. So the schedule sets up nicely for the Bulldogs, Joe. their three really toughest opponents probably coming at the end.
They'll get, you know, they'll be able to work on a lot of things throughout the season, and the only thing that they have to worry about, well, yeah, we're looking ahead maybe a little too much, but if they get through that part of the season before the final three games with not many injuries, that'll be good for them.
Well, one thing we talk about with every team, Joe, is depth.
Yeah.
I think of all the teams I've seen this year, Berwick has the most depth out of anybody in District 2. Quality depth. Maybe Valley West because of a bigger school. Maybe Delaware Valley, a bigger school.
Brought down by number 55, Joseph Lynn. Third and 13.
Dallas still has the ball. This is their longest drive of the evening, I think. Time-wise, anyway. Third and 13 for the Mountaineers. Starbucks.
Yeah. He swings it out. He hits Carl Markowski. He's a senior. Fourth down on the way for Dallas. But Michael Starbuck, number 15, the quarterback. He'll be the
he's a freshman.
Replacement next year when Manella leaves.
You would think, but Coach Manella this week talked about this system that he has of cross-training, of players playing multiple positions. And if you're a quarterback one season, you might not be a quarterback the next season if there's someone else that can play and you can be used in another position. He was talking about that, and that's why he wants to have all this young depth.
Starbuck
being chased, and he might get it. I think he got it.
Doe for the first down near the 30, and the chains will move.
Starbuck on the keeper. Brought down by number 55, Joseph Flynn. And number 40.
Maybe the JV game Monday will be more competitive than the varsity game.
So I think if the Mountaineers could score on this drive, it would send the folks home with a little better taste in their mouth.
Yeah, a little bit, as Dylan Schuster takes it up. So Aaron Dugan has a preview of tonight's sports show. Aaron, what do we have?
That's right, Bob. It's the best time of the year. The sports show is back tonight at 11 on Fox 56. Well, you'll hear from Frank Sheptock a little bit more. Bob, your feature where he gets to talk a little bit about what brought him back to coaching on the high school level, and you hear some sound from him on the field coaching. It's very interesting. We also talk with the Lake Lehman girls field hockey team. They have five girls going to D1 or D2 schools, Temple, St. Francis, Louisville. They're going to be a very good team this year. You'll also hear from the Lakeland cheerleaders and the Valley View band. They have a very excellent band, and we'll show one of their performances from last week. And in our Get to Know segment, where we talk to some athletes off the field, we have Mount Carmel's Manus McCracken. And, Bob, I know you know what his hidden talent is, and you can't miss it tonight at 11.
The Mount Carmel boy, McCracken? Yeah, you don't want to miss that. If you like Bob Dylan, you definitely want to tune in and see McCracken do a nice rendition of little Bob Dylan. He sounded just like him, too. And he did the whole song.
It's amazing that a high school kid knows Dylan.
Exactly. Those media days were a lot of fun. The kids really opened up to us, especially when we asked some of their hobbies.
Yeah.
And so you want to stay tuned to the sports show. We got a couple kids that sing, one that juggles. A lot of interesting hobbies and talents you would never know.
And you guys do one heck of, you know, as someone that isn't a part of your company, you guys have graciously invited me to do this week, and I truly appreciate it. But you guys do it. Heck of a job on the Fox 56 Sports Show. I mean, you guys are really in-depth throughout the season. You just don't do football. You just don't do basketball. You guys dig in-depth on all sorts of interesting stories of all sorts of sports, and you guys should be commended.
Oh, thank you very much, Joe, and we appreciate you coming out tonight. Knew it was a lot of fun. Been a lot of fun. Starbuck.
Well, there you go.
Up through about the 16-yard line.
It's fun to watch the left-hander.
Yeah. Now, here's what Dallas has. coming up. Of course, they'll go to Pittston. And Pittston is playing very tough against Tuncanning. They're actually winning 21-14. Scranton Preps could be looking for their first win by that week. Valley West going to be a tough game. Wyoming area tough. Hazleton and that big playing, got to play for the old shoe. The old shoe back here. It will be at Lake Lehman this year.
On the black turf.
And the black turf. And, you know, that could be a district playoff game because both teams are in separate divisions this year. Lake Lehman 3A. That's Starbuck. Gets the first down up to about the 6. Dallas will be 4A. And both teams could be headed to some sort of playoff.
Now, if a left-hander is running to his right, it's pretty much going to be a run.
Pretty
now watch
much.
This. Yep.
Unless you're Tim Tebow.
Unless, well,
he's going to run too.
Yeah, he ran it, and he's been the most entertaining player on the Mountaineers.
Yep, first to goal, Dallas. You even saw the band get up.
Yep.
Under a minute to play here at Mountaineer Stadium. Starbuck to the end zone. Oh, great defense by Berwick. Jacob Betts.
They could get one more play in here.
Yeah,
they could get one more play to get rid of the goose egg.
Because the clock doesn't stop.
Yep.
No, they're going to call timeout.
Oh. All right. This means something. This means something.
Yep. Jack Farrell, a ninth grader, was the intended receiver. So our players of the game. Matt Champ, who caught the opening touchdown pass for Marshman. And then Len Wida, who had 4 touchdowns tonight. He'll be the other player of the game. We'll talk to them after the clock hits 0.
The one-handed catch. That's the one that grabbed it for me. That is a beautiful play. And he did it with the left hand.
I know. How about Marshman's behind the Marshman's block?
Yeah, that was
a nice Hunter.
Play.
Even
that
though the play didn't count, because you know the play didn't count because there was a penalty.
But that play was right there for Marshman.
Yeah,
that,
it was.
That was on a golden platter here.
He didn't hit him in the back or anything.
Nope.
So here we go. Can Dallas score? Last play of the game, most likely.
Oh
no! Shooting 3 through is the Berwick defense. And we'll call his name again, Joseph Lynn with the sack.
And that, oh, timeout.
Timeout. Timeout. Yep, call timeout.
So where are you guys going to be next week?
Funny you should ask. We'll be at Danville next week as we'll, we'll be at Danville next week as when Montoursville comes to down. Both teams should be undefeated going into that game. Of course, Bryson Mussina is the guy we talk about, quarterback. We saw him last year against Lewisburg. He is the son of Mike Mussina.
I kind of figured.
Yeah, that's a name. Montoursville, Mussina.
The father's an athlete, of course. The gene pool.
Yeah.
The kid's got to be a pretty good athlete, too.
He is, and Mike is actually the basketball coach.
Is he really?
Yep, absolutely. He still lives in Montoursville. Real nice guy. So both teams going to run on the field. 18 seconds remaining. Third down on the way. Berwick going to blitz again. Going to throw a little fade, and it's intercepted, and that will do it.
That'll do it.
Picked off in the end zone by number 88, Malik McMillan, a junior defensive back, and the band played on.
McMillan.
Nice. Nice interception to end the game. Keep the shutout preserved for the Berwick Bulldogs. And what do we have? Still 5 seconds left, I guess, on change of possession.
Yep, got to run one more play. So here's our upcoming schedule. We talked about next week. We'll be at Danville. And then September 16th, it will be Scranton at North Pocono. So that should be a great game. Scranton is beating Honesdale tonight. North Pocono has Abington Heights on Saturday.
How about that Scranton game from last week? It took 3 hours, I heard?
Yeah, over 3 hours.
Jeez.
And that's what's amazing about the Hazleton tonight.
Yeah.
Valley West put up 40-some points. They only have 6 on the board right now. So that will do it. That's the last play of the game.
And that's the end of the game. Final score.
And Berwick moves to 2-0 on the season as the Friendship now will kick back up. Both coaches go to the middle of the field. They give a big hug to one another. And I'm sure they'll talk later on. The final score, Berwick 42, then Dallas nothing. So, Joe, quickly, we knew it could happen.
Yeah.
First play of the game, Berwick showed they were here to play, and that just about did it.
Yeah, right from the start, they put the foot down, and there was no stopping the Bulldogs throughout the rest of the game. They just, they outplayed them, and they just have a lot more talent than Dallas right now. Dallas has a lot of young players, a lot of inexperienced players on the team. They'll get better. They've got a good coach. They will get better. But Berwick, I think Berwick could get better too.
Well, only goes up for Berwick.
Yeah.
Thank you. So we'll take a quick timeout. We'll try to get to our players of the game when we return.
You're watching the Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY.
Are you ready? I'm ready to learn the skills that lead to a career, not just a job. I'm ready to earn a degree, not a lot of debt. I'm ready for a powerful degree that will transfer to other colleges and universities. My mind is ready. I'm ready for Luzerne County Community College.
Only Wendy's can make the Baconator, because while some other guys use frozen beef from far away,
that's 9,429 miles away.
Wendy's only uses fresh beef from ranches close by,
so we don't have to freeze it.
Then add 6 strips of bacon, cooked fresh in an oven, never a microwave. Tossed with plenty of
cheese,
without a single veggie to get in the way.
Aww. Proving once and for all
that only Wendy's has the bacon and the ater to make the Baconator.
Learn to see.
Learn to speak.
Bail.
Awesome.
Learn to solve. Ready to inject the sample?
Learn the balance.
Nice.
Learn to fly.
So, Coach Sheptock talking to his victorious team for the Berwick Bulldogs. They put a dominant performance on against an overwhelmed Dallas Mountaineer team.
Yeah, right from the word go, Dallas was off to the races on their first offensive play from scrimmage, and from that point on, they weren't stopped.
No, they weren't, so we'll get down to Aaron Dugan shortly, but 2-0 start for Frank Sheptock, and the shutout continues, which is even more impressive.
Yeah, and 40 points last week, 45 points this week, so 85 to nothing after the first 2 weeks. That'll put you on top of just about any standings in North America.
Oh, that Wyoming area better watch out next week for the Warriors. I mean, here comes Berwick rolling right into town, and that defense, probably the most impressive part.
Wow, and I think they can get better. I think the more they work at it, the more Marshman connects with Force and the other receivers. Wida is just a very impressive running back, and they've got those big guys up front. Who knows how far these Berwick Bulldogs can go?
We'll find out. Let's see. Aaron Dugan's going to talk to them now on the field. Aaron?
Coach, not a lot of negative things you can say about that game. Got it done offensively, defensively. We got to be very proud.
Sure, very proud. Quality win forced against a quality opponent. Whenever you're able to go on the road into a place where there's a lot of tradition and play this well, hats off to our players. I mean, we have great senior leadership. We have great focus. And I tell you what, we've got great team camaraderie and unity. And I think that that's what's been demonstrated in the first 2 weeks. We're playing complete football. couldn't be more proud of our boys.
You're a defensive guy. I know you love that defense. Defense was so solid tonight. But offensively, how great is it for you to be able to get guys that can run and guys like Champ that can catch those balls?
Well, we're trying to make defenses defend all the skill players. And we have a lot of skill players that obviously can make plays. We're doing a good job of distributing the football, and where a team just can't hone in on one person. And you know, it's tough on the defense, and you know, we've got playmakers. I mean, you know, it's easy putting the ball in these guys' hands and letting them watch them play, and you know, great effort on their part. They're very talented. I think what you see is the hard work that our boys put in and the maturity that they've developed over the course of the last 8 months is really showing.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, let's move on to some of those playmakers Coach was talking about. Len Wida making it look pretty easy out there tonight. You're a very talented back, but man, your line was really doing work for you.
Yeah, I'm proud of them. You know, we're going to try to keep it up all year. You know, we just can't get satisfied. You know, we'll go out and win every game just like that one.
Talking with Coach about, you know, how much heart you guys have, just talk about the team camaraderie this year.
You know, it's just like family. We're out here playing, like, it's just fun. It's, I wouldn't say an easy thing, but we love it.
You're 2-0 now. How good does it feel to get this season started and get two wins under your belt?
Good. It's definitely a confidence booster. You know, there were some doubts about us, but I'm glad we can show them what we got.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Let's move on to our next player of the game, Matt Champ, getting things done out there. First, take me through some of those catches. I mean, you were like Odell out there tonight. That's what the guys in the booth were saying.
Yeah, thank you for that. But I just do what I got to do for my team, just make do the best ability. My quarterback, great guy, Jared Marshman, get me the ball, put in, give me the ability to make those plays. I just got to thank him a lot.
How great is it to have somebody to bounce off of like Len? You know, he can really run the ball, and it's got to make you feel so confident.
Oh, it does, definitely. Lenny's a good buddy of mine, and he's a heck of a running back. He's really can do a lot of spectacular things for his size, and nobody doubts him. He's a heck of a player.
Where would you like to see the rest of the season go?
I like to see the rest of the season go. We continue to play like we are and just continue to get better and stronger and go undefeated. Everybody wants that. Make it a states and put up a fight.
All right, great game tonight.
All right, thank you very much.
All right, back to you guys.
I'm not sure if he practices that one-handed grab, but that's definitely a highlight maker.
Yeah, no doubt about it, and that one will be in the reels for the whole season.
Joe, thanks for coming on. Did you have fun?
Bob, I had a great time. I want to thank everyone from Fox 56 and MyTV. You made me feel at home, and you couldn't have made it any easier. It was almost idiot-proof, which is...
which is good for us.
Yeah.
Good for us. So,
good for me.
An easy win for Berwick. They go to 2-0. Dallas falls to 0-2, but plenty of games left on the schedule. Next week, of course, we'll be at Danville. Mountaineersville takes on the Ironmen, and that kickoff will be at 7 o'clock. So for the entire Fox 56 Sports crew, including Aaron Dugan, Joe Thomas, this is Bob Hyde saying so long from Mountaineer Stadium.
Rivalry of the Week on MyTV WQMY.